And welcome back, friends, for Reading Time with CJ. Thank you so much for joining me today so that we can read and explore more books together. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you can stay up to date on all the new and exciting books that we can read together. So do you know what book we're going to be reading today? This book is called The Perfect Pair by Rachel Harrison. Are you ready to read along with me? Let's go! The Perfect Pair by Rachel Harrison. Here's a story about a friendly bear. Bear is on the look for his perfect pair. Bear lives in the woods and likes to play, but he's so big he scares others away. So Bear put on a sports day and invited animals to come and play. Some animals said no as they were scared, but five said yes and came prepared. Giraffe, ant, frog, bird, and hare all came to compete with Bear so that he could find his perfect pair. The animals lined up, ready to compete. Bear wanted to see who he would defeat. The first game was a 100 meters race. They all began to run at their own pace. Bird flew up high and could hardly see. Giraffe walked slow and got caught in a tree. Frog took quick jumps and moved forward with ease. Hare followed after and ran like the breeze. Ant was smart and held on to Bear. They ran so fast so that no one came near. The first race was done and Giraffe came last. Bear said,
I thought Giraffe was fast. Well, it seems Giraffe can't be my perfect pair, neither can Bird, as she's still lost in the air.
Left were Ant, Frog, Hare, and Bear. Now, who would be Bear's perfect pair? For the next game, they all had to cross the sea. Bear shouted, "On your marks, get set! 1, 2, 3! Frog kicked through the sea as fast as she could. Hare followed after Frog and was quite good. Ant floated and cried, "Bear, this isn't fair. I don't think we'll make a very good pair." Ant came last and left Frog, Hare, and Bear. Now who would be Bear's perfect pair? The last game was a tug of war between Frog and Hare. The one to pull the other will be Bear's perfect pair. Bear stood back to see which one would win. He was so nervous he could hardly hold it in. Hare pulled the rope with all his might. Frog pulled back, though Hare wasn't light. Pulling this way, pulling that way. Then Hare pulled a bit more and dragged Frog across the floor. Frog was quite sad and said to Bear, "That was fun and I did come near. We may not be a perfect pair, but let's all do this again next year." So Hare had won fair and square and was over the moon to be Bear's perfect pair. The end.
I hope you enjoyed reading along with me, girls and boys, and I really hope to see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.